Hi, welcome to your channel, The Ancients, the channel where we share with you the best tips of Vastu, numerology and astrology to ensure your prosperity, peace of mind and health for you and your family. Today, we are going to be speaking about Vastu tips for your garden. I have already shared with you in the first video on the channel 10 lucky plants for your garden. The planning of your garden will significantly impact your health, your prosperity, your mood. Lush greenery helps in relaxing and brings peace of mind, relieves stress. Therefore, it's very important that we have and understand what are the Vastu principles for our garden. Before we go on to the Vastu principles, could I request you to please subscribe to the channel The Ancients by pressing the subscribe button and also pressing the bell icon so that you get every update on every new video which I release for you. Please also do share these videos with your friends and family so that they too can benefit by using the Vastu principles for prosperity, health and peace of mind. Let's start with the tips for our garden. Small shrubs should be placed in the east and north of our garden. Tall trees should always be in the west, south or southwest of the garden. They give financial stability. Ensure that the shadow of your trees does not fall on your house. Useful trees, which I have already shared a few in the earlier video, but I am repeating them again, to have in your garden are coconut, neem, sandalwood, lemon, pomegranate, mango, amla, Ashoka tree, etc. Plants which are good for your garden are money plant, tulsi, flower plants such as jasmine, lotus, ganda phool, chameli, raat ki rani, hibiscus, orchid. Please avoid thorny plants and cactus in your garden. They give negative energy and spoil the positivity of the house. Lawn is best in the north or northeast of your house. Small water bodies or waterfall can also be there in the east, north or northeast. Bench can be kept in the east or north so that whenever you are sitting on the bench, please always face the north or east. This will give you better health. North, avoid always heavy trees, clutter and rock garden. Lawn must be always maintained neat and clean. The dry leaves, fallen leaves, clutter and garbage must not be allowed to stay in the garden. In the south, always avoid pets, water bodies and swings. In the east, no big trees, no clutter and no rock garden. No milk-bearing plants should be in the garden in your house. No bonsai plants should be kept in your house or in your garden. They draft the growth, they stop the growth of the inmates of the house. No dead or leafless plants should be in front of the home. Trees must be planted in even numbers. Do not cut trees in the month of Bhadrapada and Magh. Cotton, Imli or known as tamarind, banyan tree, peepal tree should be avoided in your compound. They should be placed outside your compound as much as possible. Neem tree also should be outside your compound. Never cut a peepal tree. Always, if it has come up in your house or in your garden, please offer prayer to it and don't only cut the people tree. Also, it's very important for you to know that the garden plays a very, very significant role in your health, wealth, and prosperity. Follow these basic principles which I've shared with you for your health, wealth, and peace of mind. Vastu principles are very, very important for your garden. I once again request all of you who have come on to the channel to please subscribe to the channel by pressing the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon so you get every video which I release for you. Please also feel free to share these videos with your friends and family so that they too can follow the Vastu principles and ensure their prosperity, health, and peace of mind. Till we meet again with another amazing video on Vastu, numerology, and astrology, stay safe, all the best, good luck.